Hello, I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
And I'm Alan.
Welcome to Less Code, More Power. Today, we're going to hear from Alan on how he uses technology to improve our environment as well as our local workspace. Hello, welcome to Less Code, More Power. I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
And today we've got an incredible guest, Mr. Alan Chai. So Alan, tell us about you. Tell us everything.
Well, I'm just a guy who loves to solve problems, yeah.
I'm just a guy, that's so
I'm
humble.
I'm just a guy who likes to solve problems.
A country guy.
Yeah, a country guy who likes to solve problems. So Alan is from Schlumberger, and he's with us on campus this week, doing a bunch of exec visits and such. So of course we had to drag him into the studio so he could tell his story to all of you. So tell us what that story is. Tell us all about how you got started with Power Apps. What does the Power Platform mean to you? And of course, like, what's next? What are all the cool things you're looking forward to?
Sure, yeah. So I started the journey not too long ago, actually. I'm quite late into the game compared to the emeritus chair around the network.
Wow.
I started by actually have a problem to solve, which is to stop people from people dying from heart attack.
Yeah. Wow!
So, wow! No big deal. Yeah. Okay.
So yeah. I create apps to get people to stay active, and to have a healthy lifestyle. Yeah.
So you did this in your company.
Yes.
So yeah. At Schlumberger, you had a colleague who passed away, unfortunately, and Alan said, "This is stupid." So he made a power app. And how did you even discover Power Apps? Because it's not like one day someone says, I'm going to build a Power App, and they've never heard of it. So how did that happen?
So actually, I discovered by chance. I was playing around on Office 365. Mm-hmm. It was deployed across the tenant, and then I clicked on the Office waffle icon. Yes.
Oh, yeah, everyone loves a good waffle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a bunch of icons show up. There's something sounds like an app, but it has a power in front, so it must be powerful. So.
Yeah, I like that. Good naming. Yeah.
That's amazing. And I know that, like, kind of you're very people focused. So tell us more about, like, kind of this, like, especially like from your friends and like kind of that, like, kind of all that happening. Mm-hmm. How did you go from there building the app to where you are now?
Yeah. So for me, I'm a very visual person. Mm-hmm. I believe in having beautiful things. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So even when I built the apps initially, I wasn't satisfied with the look and feel. That has come from the box, and I like to challenge myself to take it to the next level and make it really stunning, and so that I can have the great adoption from my user.
I love it.
So I want to make sure my user likes the app, they like to come back again, and like to use it.
That's cool. That's
so you made this a kind of health tracker app, like for people to go get miles in, right, for running?
Correct. Yeah.
Okay. And to this day, you built this app. How many people did you think would adopt it?
So for that app, we track the number of miles we run as a company.
Yeah.
Initially, we just want to do a full circle run of all the offices around Europe, which is about 22,000 kilometers. Mm-hmm. But we achieved that in 2 weeks.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
So after 1 year of the app being in use, we actually did more than 400,000 now.
400,000?
Yeah.
Okay. Wow. Wow, that's amazing.
That's to the moon and back, right? Isn't that the distance to the moon and back?
That's nuts, though. Like, it must make you feel like, does it bring you happiness, like in terms of, or joy, in terms of the kind of the difference that you're making there?
Absolutely. I mean, the real difference is not the numbers, is when I see the people's changing. Mm-hmm. I've known a person that she started off oversized, overweight in the range of 200 over pounds, and today, after using the app, in 18 months, she's a marathon runner.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
One of your colleagues was overweight. 2 years of using this app, she's now running marathons.
Yes.
That's why.
Wow. So, yeah. Like, we always talk about how the Power Platform can help people in their role and stuff, but also maybe we don't talk about it enough, and we should do, the fact that those people can help other people. Mm-hmm. And, like, look at that person, their lives changed.
Yeah. Absolutely. That's wild. Yeah.
Yeah.
Super cool.
So for me, it's the tangible thing, seeing your friends mm-hmm. change, right? Their yeah. life change because of the tools, the solution that we try to push out there to solve a problem, right?
That's amazing. Yeah.
So cool. So that wasn't the only power app you've built. In the last few years, you've built how many power apps?
Last count from yesterday, so 91.
91 wow. power apps
yeah.
for Schlumberger
yeah.
in how many years? 2 years?
In 2 years.
In 2 years.
That's right.
That is a ridiculous number of yeah. apps. Yeah. yeah. That is so interesting. And you've realized that your company really benefits from these apps. And this is what you do now.
Yeah.
This did not used to be your job. And now it's become, you are the head of digital transformation for Schlumberger. So this is your entire job, is to build apps, build teams, to help them learn to build apps, et cetera. That is super, super cool.
Yeah, so coming from the maker side mm-hmm. into the dark side, now I need to make sure that I am able to replicate myself.
That's right.
Because there is no point having one single hero trying to drive the organization right. to make app. You want to be successful, you need to have multiple of me, mm-hmm. right? So this year, my aim is to multiply myself, clone myself 20 times in 2020.
Chai clones.
That's amazing.
I love it.
Yeah. Okay. And so that I can elevate 20 power makers, yeah, to be able to do what I do mm-hmm. In across various business unit,
yes,
and bring the adoption to the next level.
Amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you're going to grow 20 versions That's of yourself. Cool. Or, so the goal is you're going to have 20 app makers at the end of this year.
20 power user. Yeah. So they are not just app maker,
yeah.
but they are solution solver.
Yes.
Yeah. Business problem solver.
Yes.
They are embedded in the business.
Oh, yeah. Embedded.
So you can scale basically.
Can scale up.
So like yeah. from yeah. a, you know, it's really interesting how you've put that, because you know, it's about knowing that as a single person, mm-hmm. we're, you know, as amazing as a person can mm-hmm. be, you know, that's like, there's a limit to that.
That's right.
Like an absolute limit. And mm-hmm. the fact that you're then going to go out there and coach people, you're going to yes. bring them in, you're going to, again, change their lives and stuff and bring yeah. all of that kind of stuff in.
I really like the fact that they're embedded in the business units.
Yeah.
Because often we will clone ourselves and have them all be in IT mm-hmm. or have them all be in like the digital transformation unit.
Yeah.
So when you say within the business units, do you mean like supply chain, finance, marketing, et cetera?
That's right. Yeah. So we have supply chain, mm-hmm. finance, and even HSC, you know, safety department.
Oh, the
yeah.
safety part. Yeah.
So they are embedded into the business.
Mm-hmm.
They look at the business problem day to day. They know the fire.
Yes.
And you equip them with the tools
right.
to be able to solve problem right there. Right.
Right.
So that actually also encourage innovation at the edge of the business.
I love yeah. that, because mm-hmm. your company, Schlumberger, is 100,000, 100,000
100,000, yeah.
That's, you said something like 85 countries?
Yes.
That's a lot of countries.
Yeah.
I know.
And I think yeah. that, like, so there's a lot of people that say the Power Platform isn't scalable mm-hmm. for enterprise.
That's right.
I think that you've proven them wrong.
Yes.
Yeah, it's definitely very scalable, yeah. Mm-hmm. The recipe into the scaling is not about just scale, but make sure that you scale in a structured manner, and at the same time keeping it safe, right?
Right.
So you want your maker to be able to run
right.
and run safely,
yeah. right?
Yeah,
with guardrails.
Correct, with guardrails.
That's right.
Cool. Yeah. But still be empowered at the same time.
Correct.
That's
still
right.
empowered at
Have
the same
the
time, and not limiting in terms of their agility, their mm-hmm. innovation power. Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
So Alan is very passionate about making things look beautiful, but also functional, because mm-hmm. you fully understand if an app is easy and beautiful to use, people are far more likely to use it, as proven by the 400,000 miles to the moon and back.
Yep.
So tell us what you've got to show us, show the audience today.
Yeah, so I like to show everyone the next project that I'm embarking on.
Mm-hmm.
This is still in the making, in the design stage.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. As we all know, we are aggressively across the world. Everybody needs to do their part to save the world.
Yes.
Yeah. To reduce our carbon footprint.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm going to do next is work on an app to gamify the carbon footprint awareness program at individual level.
Interesting.
Yeah. Nice. Okay.
So it's almost like a game that you will be assigned a certain task. For example, Donna, when you play the game in the app, you'll receive a task for, say, next week, you're going to avoid single-use plastic bottle.
Oh, I like that. Okay.
10 times.
That's right.
That's pretty cool. It allows people to actually do something that they
correct.
Can do.
Something very practical.
Something practical, something that we can teach or educate individuals about their role, what they can contribute in terms of reducing the carbon footprint. Wonderful. Reducing carbon footprint is not just an enterprise responsibility,
right.
It's also individual.
Yeah. That's right. We as employees own these commitments we make, right? We were talking a lot about Microsoft's commitment to be carbon negative by the year 2050. And this is the kind of thing that can really help us a lot, because we as employees all want to say, how do we contribute to this, right? Sure, ride bicycles more, bring reusable cups more. What else do we do?
Right, share.
Share rides.
Yeah, even things like, for example, in the weekend, you chose to go to a local farmer's market.
Yes.
And buy local produce.
Ah, that's right.
Rather than
that's
having a fish that is air flown somewhere else.
Right.
Yeah. With all the carbon footprint.
Oh. Yeah. Go meatless.
Yeah.
Also that. okay, cool. So tell us about this app you're designing. This is very, very cool.
Yeah, so this app, as you can see on the screen, it will have the user profile describing your persona. You can create your superpower character. We're going to call it Green Bucks.
Yeah. Yep.
And then from there, you will see there's some activity category where you'll be given some tasks, bike to work, use public transport, or do avoid single-use bottles. Yeah. And eat local.
Yes.
Yeah. And then on the third part, we have this share and inspire section, whereby I mentioned you discover some great tips to do the reduction of carbon footprint. Mm-hmm. You share through the app, and you earn more points. Yeah.
Cool. So that's the sharing of, like, say for example, I got assigned a task and I found a great way to do that task.
Yes.
I can share like how I do that. So when someone else gets assigned that, they can go ahead and take that tip.
Correct. And you gain the points.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah. I like this.
Win-win. Yeah.
Look at this.
And when you gain the point, you gain a badge. Yeah.
Nice.
New badge. Yeah.
So
with that, we do some challenges between individuals.
I love that. You guys have some really fun apps at Schlumberger, by the way.
So by the way, this app, I intend to make it public because it doesn't need to be restricted to a single company, right?
That community template.
Yeah, community template.
We are 100% going to use this app at Microsoft, just so you know.
I don't know if you know Keith Watlin. I think everyone knows Keith Watlin. He did a Templates for Humanity kind of like effort, and I totally think that needs to be in there.
I think it should be a template
for humanity.
Keith, you're getting homework also.
Yep.
This is so cool, Alan. I love this. And, you know, I love the fact that it's something so practical. All of these people at Schlumberger and around the world can use this, apply this, and then come up with their own ideas on what kinds of apps they can build to reduce this environment impact in their own area. It's so cool.
Yeah. And so this trip, I just finished a lunch with INC.
Oh, yeah.
Deshaun.
Yes.
And INC has similar sustainability program.
That's right.
So we are actually going to collaborate together.
That's amazing. That.
Yeah. Yeah.
So just for the rest of you, the INC team is the customer success org here who works with Power Platform. And they just had an all-hands meeting this morning, and Alan actually presented there, brought down the house. People are crying. It was intense. It was intense. He was the star of the show today. But one of the most interesting conversations we've had in that team was talking about the UN sustainability goals. And how we, Microsoft, can contribute to those sustainability goals. And now you are working with us and the UN as well.
That's right.
That's amazing.
That is wonderful. Super, super awesome. Cool.
Great.
So, of course, we never exit a show without assigning you homework.
Nope.
So, Alan, what assignment do you have for our audience?
Give us the homework.
Homework, okay.
Yes.
Let me think about this.
I mean, you don't have to go small. Yeah. Like, this is something that, like, people can do, like, right now.
Yes.
So, like, this isn't something where, you know, oh, okay, I'll get to it in, like, next week no. or like okay. 6 months. This yeah. needs to
something
be
something
like,
they can do today.
Yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. So I am a pretty practical person.
Yes.
So if I want to give you a homework, I want to make sure that homework is useful for you.
Yes.
So the homework is go talk to your kids, if you have kids, or your nieces or nephews. Find someone who is 10 years old or below.
Mm-hmm.
Ask them, what is their biggest problem today? And take that problems and try to solve it.
That's pretty cool. That's a,
that is
that's
interesting.
A cool takeaway.
And then you could probably co-create some sort some of yeah, tech yeah. solution
create.
With oh,
right.
them.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. That is fascinating.
And also like bring them like if you can and mm-hmm. hopefully like kind of it's like working together with those people with the problems like
right.
show them what you make and
that's
show them
right.
what
absolutely.
You do and stuff and
yeah.
get them involved in a power platform.
Yeah.
So I love that.
If you want some tips, so I practice that same model with my daughter
yeah,
over the Thanksgiving holiday.
Mm-hmm.
So she says she wants to build an app with me. So mm-hmm. I say, okay, yeah, I will teach you, but let's build something relevant.
That's right. That's
so she,
cool.
I challenge her to say, what is your problem? She said, the biggest problem is her Harry Potter trading cards app and all the Pokemon cards. Right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So she said, okay, we need an app to manage this.
App management, card management app.
That's
correct.
Cool.
I love that.
And
okay.
she built that in 1 hour.
I remember seeing
in
this
one
on
hour.
Twitter.
In one hour. What? And how old is she?
She was 10 back then.
Alan's 10-year-old builds apps faster than anyone we know. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing. Does she need a job?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So you heard the homework.
Mm-hmm.
Go find a young person in your life. Discuss with them a problem they have, a very specific local problem,
mm-hmm.
and together co-create an app, an automation, a website, a chatbot, something, and show them the power of the Power Platform. Because they should learn that they actually have the solution right in their own hands.
That's
and the power
right.
to
yeah.
change it.
That's right.
Yep.
Yes.
I love
yep.
it. It's fantastic. All right, we're out of time as always. I'm Donna.
I'm Sarah.
I'm Alan.
Thank you for joining us for Less Code, More Power. See you next time.